Warning, the video you're about to watch contains my opinion, views, and very little facts on something that you may like or enjoy. If you do not like it, you know where the door is. Enjoy the video. Hello, this is MegasmithGaming539, and I recently just finished playing Murdered Soul Suspect, so I thought I'd tell you what I thought about it. First, let me tell you a little bit about the story. Basically, you're a homicide detective who gets murdered while you're trying to solve a murder. You know, as a homicide detective, that's what you tend to do. And you're killed by the murderer of the murders, and you come back to life as a ghost. So you don't really come back to life. But you know what I mean? You come back as a ghost, and your aim is to solve your own murder. But it doesn't just... You're not just solving your own murder, you're solving this other whole case that you've already been doing. You end up meeting a psychic, not a psychic, a medium, and yeah, and you sort of solve your own murder and stuff. I won't spoil it for you, just in case you are in the middle of playing this game, but that's basically the gist of the story. So let me tell you some good things. The voice acting in this is top notch, along with the story as well, if they didn't drag it out as much as they did. And you get a real feel for some of the characters. You really get to know what some of these characters, like, you know, are there for, basically. There's no character in this that doesn't feel like he has a meaning. Every character in this feels like they should be there. It's well written. And as I say, the voice acting's very good. And some of the ideas in this, like you can walk through walls, you can possess people and read their minds. I'll get back to that later, because that's got a bit of a bad thing to it, but it's got some really good things in this game that just don't live up to how good you would think they would be, if that makes sense. But as I say, it's got some good things, and these are basically, if I think about it, all of them. You can teleport, because ghosts can do that. And you do get to almost free roam, and there's some side missions where you like solve other people's murders so they can like go up to heaven, if you know what I mean. So like you solve their murders and like, oh, I'm free, I can go to heaven, blah blah blah, and they fly up into a shining bright light. So yeah, that's about it for the good things. But every game, like every movie, like every book, like every TV series has its bad points, and this isn't short of them. It's open world, is lifeless, everybody stands still, looking like they're talking, but when you get near them, they're not actually talking. When you read people's minds after you've possessed them, they only say two things, and some people will say the same thing as somebody else. Everybody in this whole town at the time seems to be thinking exactly the same sort of things. Oh, a policeman's been murdered. Nothing about anything else, not like, oh, hey, today was a nice day, the weather was nice. You know, the average stuff that people think about in the average day of a human being. Just not in this. The gameplay is really slow with no action. So if you're one of the people like me, who like your Call of Duties, Titanfall, Tomb Raider, Mass Effect, Hitman, made by the same people, you're not gonna like this game. You know, like, I didn't like this game. I mean, don't get me wrong, some people are going to enjoy it, but I just didn't. It just didn't do anything for me. It's got no action in it, and the parts that you think might have action in them, they don't. They're just very awkward and difficult. Like, you could walk through a building to get to one part of your objective, and you have to walk back out of the building to go somewhere else. But on your way in, there'll be no danger, nothing. On your way back out, it's a house full of demons, and these demons you have to sneak up behind and then like exorcise them, and you know, do whatever you do when you exorcise somebody. And I don't mean jumping jacks, I mean like the exorcist, you know, like the last exorcism, the exorcism of Emily Rose, all these different horror films. But it's not like one of them. You exorcise these demons, but it's like I played Zelda, the Phantom Hourglass, where there's them guards in the little mazes that have like the light where they can see, if you know what I mean. It's like that. If they see you, they go for you, and then you have to hide in these little portal thingies, and it's just, oh my god, it's just so bad and so slow and so boring. But because of this, it brings down the rest of the game. It's got a good story, voice acting, soundtrack, graphics are okay. But it's just that's probably the only bad thing, and they drag the story out way too much. I mean, it's yeah, they're gonna have to give it playtime to make it value for money, but some of it's just like, oh my god, I have to walk to the other side of this fucking village again. I have to go back to the church again. I have to possess a person to walk over this thing on the floor again. It's just, oh my god, it's so boring. My brother lent me this game, so it's not actually mine. I didn't waste my money on it, he did. He played it, he completed it in a day. He said, yeah, if you're going to play this game, complete it on the day you play it. And I didn't, and I shouldn't have done that. I should have played it all the way through, because you will play this game and think, yeah, this is pretty good. I can walk through walls and shit. And then later on, about half an hour after you've got used to being able to walk through walls and solve people's murders, you just think, oh my god, what am I doing? Why have I done this to myself? Oh my god. It's just shit. As I say, the characters, other than the main characters, like the people who are there to make the world look like, you know, an open world, they just stand there waving their arms around, moving their mouths as if they're talking. They won't talk. They might say the odd couple of words, but that's it. And it just seems lifeless, which seems ironic. Well, no, not ironic. More true to the fact that you're a ghost. But yeah, it's just really boring. But anyway, before I drag on and rant on and just go on, start repeating myself, going full cycle about how bad I think this game is, I want to know what you think. If you've played this game, have mercy on your soul. Please comment below what you thought of the game. If you haven't, tell me what you think of the trailers, and then play it. And then tell me if you thought it lives up to its expectations for the trailers that made this game look really awesome. But anyway, this is MegSmithGaming539. I will see you in the next video. Peace.